Hello everyone, Asmodeus here, and welcome to episode 25 of my Sevtech Aegis series. Today I want to work on moving on to the next age. Moving on, we need to continue and see if we can get our coal generator made. For our coal generator, okay. Let's try that again. Or is our engine? There we go. Coal engine. That's right. Need the celestial altar. I believe last episode we got the majority of these parts. Let's see, we have them in here. I think the only thing we were missing were the fiery gears. 4, 2, 1, 4, 2. No, and I need another seared furnace controller as well. That's right. So we need to do the controller and the fiery gears. Didn't do very much between episodes. Ran back to Twilight Forest, picked up our fiery blood so we can make our ingots. We have 4, so we need 12 more ingots so we can get those. Wrong thing. Here we go. Get those starting to cook. For our smeltery controller, we need to go find another crimson middle gem, make a furnace, and we need more seared brick. I have the seared brick. We need to make a furnace. Now we just need another one of those gems. Oh, it's naturally I start recording and it's night, so let's sleep real quick. Let's see, backpack. Since we are heading to the Between Lands, let's go ahead and get those tools. Shovel, pick, weedwood sword. Kind of swap some things out here. All right, let's go. Oh, do I have my raft on me? I think when I was exploring it to do our first smeltery controller, I think I remember marking the location of another gem on the map. So let's go check that out. I do have something marked here. Let's see what that is. It looks like that might be what we're looking for. That wasn't too hard. The the Betweenland and Twilight Forest, I mean, they're cool mods. I just need to take some time to explore them a little more and learn about them and improve fighting skill, because, yeah. If you're not much of a Minecraft fighter, then probably not the best mod for you. Oh, wait. What am I doing? If I recall... I could be wrong, but I do believe you have to run it through the purifier. Well, it's doing something. Okay. So we have our jam. I guess we could just use this here. Put that there, that there. Grab that. All right. So we're one step closer. I think that's what we needed. Yeah, okay. I'd have been upset if I made the wrong controller. The between lands again, fine. Alright, and we're back. Let's see, which way are we facing? We go. So the only thing we're missing now are the gears. So let's go check on our iron and see about getting the gears made. Controller. In this chest. I think it is. That was the last seared brick, so we'll just throw that in there for now, I guess. I suppose I could have just went through and made a block and hammered it out, but too late now. We'll do that with the next one. Just 9, 10. Four more. That wasn't it. Let's throw you back in there. All right, so for the gear, we need a gear cast. So stone gear, just a wooden gear surrounded by stone, wooden gear we've made before. So I've already made the stone gear. Let's go ahead and make our gear cast now that we're here. And then I believe we just combine this with this, and that gives us our fire ingots. And then we have to throw these into the smelter. To create our gears. Then we need to pack everything up and go to our celestial altar. Click. One, two. Okay, put in the rest of our fire ingots. Switch these out. Start casting some gears. You need a little bit of room in my inventory, so just throw that in there. Just for now, throw these things that I got in Twilight Forest in here. Throw that in there, that in there. If I have any space in here. Nope. Definitely going to need to do something about my inventory issue here. Are those in there? I don't have space for those. Let's take that out. Put our chisel away. Put all that away. Grab that sword. Those tools. Okay, should be good. All right, there's one, three more to go. Let's see the wheat. Let's just put up in here. Dust should technically go in here. Space, so let's put it up there. And let's grab all of our materials that we need. So they're ready to go. And hopefully our altar has enough star power in it to do this. Otherwise, we're going to have to do a little bit of more of astral sorcery. My wand. Is that in here or is it in my backpack? There. What about here? Resonating wand. There we go. Alright. Oh, night again. Every time I come up out of my little rabbit hole, it's night. Alright. Let's go set this thing up and see how close we are. If you recall from past episodes, we ended up rebuilding the altar way out here in this corner. Because that's where the starlight was the strongest. So if we don't have enough, then we might have to look at making focusing crystal or something like that. Not super familiar with this mod, so that's something we'll have to figure out. Anvils and chests in the corner. Okay. Oh, is this even the right table? Celestial altar. That's a starlight crafting altar. Oh, do we need to upgrade the altar again? Might have to rethink this. Maybe we won't get out of this age in this episode. Okay. And back to spring. So, what is it we have set up over here? I don't recall. Okay, so we have the lower level, the luminous crafting table here, light well. All right, so let's go put our materials away and then see what we need to do to upgrade our altar. That's not it, that's not it. Don't see it there. How about over here? Astral Tome. Okay. Okay, not in here. How about in attunement? Where is ritual pedestal? Okay. Okay, that's the one we have. Maybe I need to progress farther in order to learn it. Okay, so I don't even see the crafting table that we need. All I see is the celestial altar, and we need, well, it says celestial altar. Okay. Okay, so this must be the next tier because this requires Twilight Forest materials. Live root, cave illuminators, Firefly jar. A rock crystal. Okay. And ironwood ingot. Alright. Let's see. I have some stone, I believe, different maze stones that I collected. Probably not the right ones. I'll have to go back. Let's see. Where would I place them? Maybe back in Twilight? Alright, well, let's see what we need for an ironwood ingot. That is what that was, right? Ironwood ingot. So raw ironwood materials are what? Live root, a gold nugget, and an iron ingot. Okay, so we need live root. Well, let's get a few things out of my inventory. Don't put gear there. Put this back. Right, just put this in my... Well, no, I'm going to want to refer back to that. So, alright. To the Twilight Forest we go. You guys still good? Behaving? Every once in a while I come out here and they've broken their leads and they're out wandering around. I have to make new leads. Ouch. I hear a trumpet skeleton somewhere. Or whatever to... what do I have? I have plenty of ironwood ingots. Probably pick those up in chests. Alright, so which ones do we need? Chiseled. So I have two chiseled. Oh, just enough. Then we need two decorative. These two brick. Two of those. And two mosaic maze. Okay, so we have all the stone that we need. That's good. So, basically all I need... I need a firefly jar and then cave illuminator. Okay, we can make that. Firefly jar. So, I just need a couple of live root. What do we need for a firefly jar? We might have one just here close. Firefly jar. Glass bottle and a firefly. But I did see when I was out running around some of these, and I believe that's what these are. So, maybe we just pillar up from here. Can I break it, or can I just pick it up, or how's that work? And hopefully it retains its firefly, that would be nice. Okay, firefly jar. So we have that piece. So now all we need is live root. And let's see, I have torches on me. This is good. Lag's brutal. Not exactly sure where live root spawns. Whether it's a lot deeper than I am. Or where that may be. But we'll search around. I probably ran by tons of it when I was doing like the cobalt caves and things like that, but I had no idea what I was looking at. Ah, way to trap myself in a hole. I'm hoping just some of these caves right here near my spawn will have some. I don't know if they only spawn in specific areas or anything about it, so we will do our best. Go away, creepy. Roots. I'm hoping that they say live root. And I'm not just walking by them without knowing what I'm looking at. But let's go down this way. Check this out. Nothing there. Don't feel like jumping down there. Oop. Little rebound lag going on. All right. Nothing too exciting here. So roots just give me sticks. Okay, good to know. Get out of the hole. Okay, how about down this way? I don't know. I'm beginning to think maybe I need to wait, what do we have here? Roots, roots. Where's my axe? These look different. Live root, right on. Okay. That makes me very happy. believe we've come for everything. We've gotten everything we came for out of this dimension. Got the maze stone, live root, firefly jar, ironwood ingot. Okay. All we needed were the... I can make that for materials that I have back in our base. And of course it's night. Hello, Mr. Creeper. Lag's killing me. Marble. We need two of these, so we need 8 marble, 4 aquamarine. Do we have those? We have 1. Okay, so we're gonna have to get some more aquamarine. How are we doing on marble? Well, that would be over here. 8 of that. Let's get out our chisel. That needs to be ruined. Alright, so we have 8 of those. And then we need illumination powder. So we need another aquamarine. So we're going to need some of that. Piles of sand, gunpowder, and glass shards. Do I have any glass shards left? Okay, I have 3, and I believe I needed 4. Yep, needed 4. How are we doing on sand? Do that. Can I do it in here? I can. I know I'm wasting charcoal. It is what it is, that's fine. Okay, so that gives me 4 of those. I need 4 of those. And then we needed gunpowder. That should give us everything we need for that. Gunpowder should be up here. I already have 2 on me from killing that creeper. Okay. How are we doing on time? Doing okay? Alright, can I do it in this one? Or do I have to do it in the other one? Nope. I have to do it in this one. So we have to run all the way across our plateau here again. Looks like I will be making another trip to the Deep Dark and hunting for some more aquamarine. It's not that bad now though, because I have, you know, my stairways and pathways and stuff lit, so it's not that bad. It's just a matter of finding it. It isn't exactly the most plentiful of ores to find, so. All right. irrigation powder here. These four go here. These go here. And let's see, that goes there. And gunpowder in the middle. And like a derp, I left the wand in there. All right, we will finish this eventually, I promise. I'll have to look and double check and see if our if the multi-block changes as well with the new upgraded altar. Big lag spike. I know, riveting entertainment. Running across, back and forth. But we are making really good progress. Thought we were going to be able to move on to the next age, but this is kind of an interesting little diversion. Getting a little more into the astral sorcery. There's a little gadget that the cave illuminators that we're making. That might be interesting for some of the areas where we have to go and get our resources from. Particularly some of the areas down in, like, the between lands and things like that, when we have to go down into the deep caverns and areas such as that. Might make exploring those areas, you know, a little more fun, a little easier. Kind of curious how it would work in the deep dark, considering, you know, all the deep dark is, at least, is like a big giant cave. So, kind of curious how that whole thing would work out. I wonder if I can do two of these. Oh, I need the aquamarines anyway, never mind. Alright, so before I can finish making the cave illuminators, we need to go get our aquamarines. Alright, well, let's go dump some inventory. And head to the deep dark. It'd be nice if, you know, aquamarine and the black quartz, things like that, would spawn in giant veins like the rest of the ores. That would simplify life quite a bit. Who knows, maybe down the road, geolysis will incorporate astral sorcery things and actually additions things within their ore samples, but for now, no. Okay, all of these things here, it's all part of this process. This all goes together. Chisel can go in my backpack. Really don't need this. Let's put that away. I don't need the mushroom. Just throw it in here. That ironwood ingot needs to go here. Alright, so let's go jump into our deep dark portal. Hopefully not die. I haven't been over here for a while, so hopefully down in this little area we don't have any bad things happening because we are leaving this sitting on the pedestal, but let's head up. Hopefully, it'll be fairly easy to find some ore deposits that I haven't noticed before. Because they are kind of few and far between. Over here. Hello there, spider. Where's my stairwell? There it is. Okay. What the heck? Hitting me. Glitching through the corners and hitting me. That's not cool. There's a skeleton back there. Don't really want to deal with him either. Not seeing anything here, so let's go up a little further real quick. And let's check out the hole. Wow, lagging big time today. Not really seeing anything other than a creeper. All right, still no aquamarine. We'll just sprint past these guys, move up a little higher. Not much of a level here. Alright, and this is as high as this one goes. And I believe I've explored a good chunk of this already. Yeah, so, not much to speak of. Let's just kind of run around all these guys. Still nothing. Not what I wanted to find. Oh, really not what I wanted to find. That's a whole group of them. Alright. This level is definitely a dud. Not sure what's killing him. Man, a whole lot of nothing. Okay, this is not being very productive. And I'm almost out of torches. Nothing that mobs that direction. Trumpet boys. What do we have here? Aquamarine. Okay. Let's harvest this real quick. It's too dark. Okay, that gives us 4. I just have to remember how to get down from here. There we go. Alright. So we need 2 per for the cave illuminators. Alright. So that should give us everything we need. Definitely gonna have to see about, I don't know if we need to strip mine or what we need to do, but we need to see what we can do about improving our aquamarine situation here. All right, I used to have this down pat. Now I can't remember how to get down. What happens when you don't visit an area for a long time? You can't remember all your patterns. Okay. Down this way. And we're out. And of course, it's a night again. Every time. Okay. Back safe. All right. Beginning to look like we're running out of time here. Pretty successful. Managed to get all the materials we need to go ahead and upgrade our altar. Once it's upgraded, then we can see about making our coal engine and moving on to the next stage. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. If you liked it, please hit the like button. If you really liked it, please subscribe. And until next time, have a great day.